In this edition of the Parliament Report, the House says yes to the Charter of Rights, amendment passed to nullify Pratt & Morgan, and more Jamaican drivers hold general driver's licenses. Constitutional amendments wrapped in a package called the Charter of Fundamental Rights and Freedoms received the nod from members of the House of Representatives on March 22. 51 members of Parliament voted yes to the Charter of Rights, which needed a two-thirds majority of the vote for passage. 8 members of Parliament were absent from the vote. They are Dr. Peter Phillips, Natalie Nita Headley, Olivia Grange, Michael Peart, Dean Peart, Dr. Patrick Harris, Roger Clark, and Kern Spencer. The Southwest St. Catherine's seat, formerly held by Everald Warmington, is now vacant following his resignation. The Charter of Rights has been on the parliamentary agenda for more than 17 years. It will replace Chapter 3 of the Constitution, providing for greater protection of the fundamental rights and freedoms of Jamaicans. The Charter of Rights proposes that Parliament shall pass no law and establish no organ of the state which abrogates, abridges, or infringes the fundamental rights of citizens. The Senate is to vote on the constitutional amendments before the parliamentary year ends at the end of March. If the amendments are not approved by the Senate, then the process would have to be restarted next parliamentary year. Meanwhile, the House of Representatives also passed another constitutional amendment, which is intended to nullify the Pratt and Morgan ruling of the Judicial Committee of the Privy Council. In 1993, the Privy Council ruled that in the case of Pratt and Morgan, a delay of more than 5 years in carrying out the death penalty constituted cruel and inhumane treatment contrary to the Constitution of Jamaica. The amendment has removed the 5-year stricture, making it easier for the carrying out of capital punishment. More than $360 million has been withdrawn from the Capital Development Fund, the CDF, to help pay the country's bills this financial year. Prime Minister Bruce Golding moved a resolution in Parliament on March 22, clearing the way for the withdrawal. He says the money being sought was budgeted for withdrawal. The government has projected to take $2.1 billion from the CDF, which is financed by the bauxite levy. This third withdrawal brings the total pulled from the fund to $1.9 billion this fiscal year. More than 80% of drivers in Jamaica have been certified with general driver's licenses. Members of Parliament's Public Accounts Committee, the PAC, on March 22 struggled to come to grips with that reality. Executives from the Inland Revenue Department, the IRD, made the disclosure at a PAC meeting. The IRD, which has responsibility for issuing driver's licenses, reported that of the 514,935 driver's licenses granted in the category of private in general, 78,935 were private. PAC Chairman Dr. Omar Davies says the ratio should set off alarm bells. The ratio has in fact set off alarm bells for a senior technocrat in the Ministry of Finance and the Public Service. Financial Secretary Dr. Wesley Hughes, who attended the PAC meeting, said he was also concerned about the ratio. Rosalie Brown, Commissioner of the IRD, says her department only issued general licenses based on competencies that are approved by the Island Traffic Authority. Transport Minister Mike Henry told the Parliament Report that the issuance of a larger number of general driver's licenses as against private driver's licenses may be due in part to the increased number of sport utility vehicles, SUVs, imported into the country. This has been another edition of the Parliament Report. You can leave your comments below. Until the next bulletin, I'm Edmund Campbell saying, walk good.